If you want to buy some cheap Ultimate Team coins, head over to igvault.com and use my discount code EGHD at the checkout to get yourself 6% off your order. Yes, guys, we're back with another squad builder. Today, we are building the best possible 500k team that you could build this week. Of course, we are using this new flashback Falcao, and Falcao looks incredible. He's not that expensive. I think it's about 50,000 coins to complete right now. You do get two tradable packs in return, and mostly you're gonna be using 83s and 84 rated cards. So, very affordable SBC. If you can't afford this SBC, just use another striker from Liga Santander. You can also use any hero card as a striker for under 50,000 coins, which if you're watching this video and this SBC has expired, there's plenty of heroes to choose from. You've got players like Donovan, and there's also the Saudi player. They're still usable, very good players. Without further ado though, let's get into the rest of the squad, show you what team we've built around Falcao. Now the thing is with him, he is Colombian, and you guys know I love using Cuadrado as a right back, so straight away we're getting a Nations link there, which is nice. But we're not gonna stop there with Liga Santander, we're still gonna build through the Liga Santander, and that is gonna be Benzema and Dembele as well. First time I've actually properly used Dembele. I've used him in draft, and he's really, really good. He's been amazing for so long. 5-star skills, 5-star weak foot. Really, really expensive for an 83 rated card, but he's so worth the coins. The best time to buy him if you don't want to lose coins is between 8 and 9 a.m. when rival rewards are coming out. And the reason why is everyone's sold their team, and then after that, they start buying him up again. So if you want to pick one up, make sure you buy one just before rewards come out, or as rewards are coming out. You can snipe him a little bit cheaper. Just a quick tip for you guys. And of course, we have Benzema. Benzema is one of my favorite players in the game, and I think it's because his card doesn't look as good as it actually is. Like, mostly when you see FIFA cards, you're like, okay, it has 90 plus pace and amazing shooting and amazing dribbling. It must be amazing. He only has 80 pace. Put Hunter on him. He has amazing dribbling, shooting, everything. His position. What I find most is that the AI in FIFA 23, he gets in amazing positions, and just his shooting is fantastic. He puts away so many goals just by just press and shoot. You don't have to do a lot with him to score. So basically, he's very beginner friendly, but also if you're more of an experienced player, like Elite 1 or like, you know, 20 out of 20, you can still use a player to score amazing goals as well. Now for the two midfielders, we're going to go for De Jong, and we're also going to go for Kessié. I've put Kessié in a lot of squads. When we was building this team, I was trying not to, but I just can't not. He's just so good, and there's no player that really compares to him for his price. He's just a brick wall of a CDM. So obviously when it comes to formations, 4-4-2, 4-2-3-1, 4-1-2-1-2, if you need a formation that needs that strong CDM, here's the player to go for. I've got him with a shadow chem style, and if you don't use an anchor, his strength's only 86 and aggression's 84, but it feels like 90 plus on both. He just doesn't really lose those one-on-one situations. And then we have Frankie de Jong. His shooting's not very good, but he is good in the attack with his dribbling and passing, so he does offer something not just in the midfield and defense, but also getting forwards in the attack, which is fantastic. That's why I put him in the squad. High stamina as well, so that those work rates are going to help. And then for the defense of this squad, we're going to go for a couple of Milan players. We're going to go for Tomori, and we're going to go for Theo Hernandez. Both very expensive, but Tomori this year is incredible. This is like his, I think he had a Future Stars card. I might be wrong, but I'm pretty sure he had a Future Stars card, which was like really obviously very good, except this is just his gold card. He's got a team of the week. That's a very expensive card. Couldn't fit him in for a 500k squad builder. It wouldn't make sense to put that much into just one centre back for that budget of a team, but 86 pace, 86 defending. And that's why I've put an anchor chem style, because he's already got enough pace really. So the anchor chem style is going to boost that strength and aggression, but he's just a brick wall. Very good. There's a reason why he's so expensive, and he's from Serie A. If a player's expensive and in Serie A, you know they are amazing. Theo Hernandez, another one of those players, probably one of the best left backs in this game. Maybe top two, maybe top three, without question. 93 pace, 78 defending, 83 physical stats. He's just a solid left back. He has everything you want from a left back. And again, just like Tomori, we've gone for an anchor because he's got so much pace already, but we're going to boost that strength, boost the aggression. You could make him a lengthy player, but the thing is, you're going to sacrifice more defending stats by putting an architect on him. So personally, that's why I prefer to go for an anchor chem style myself. And then for the goalkeeper on the other centre-back, we're going to go for is Bonucci. He's going to get that strong link. Well, I say strong link. I'm still talking like it's FIFA 22, but you get more chemistry if you put two players from the same team. So we've got Cuadrado and Bonucci from the same team. We've got another Milan player there in goal. So Maignan and Yeah, he's been in a lot of squads. French from Serie A with these team links. He's going to be a very popular goalkeeper pretty much all year. But Bonucci, 78 pace, 87 defending, 85 physical. Have we had a flashback Bonucci in previous FIFAs? But it seems to remind me of a card we've had before. But yeah, amazing card. Has all the right stats. He's only a little bit better than the players that you can get for under 5,000 coins. But since you're spending 500,000 coins on this team, you want to get every little ounce of stats out of your defense. So he's already high strength and aggression. That's why I've gone for a shadow. So he's going to be super quick and he's just on it. When it comes to standing tackles and defensive awareness, he is on it. And finally, with not many coins left, we're going to have to go for Rafael Leao. And yeah, you can't afford his team of the week with 500,000 coins unless the prices change over the next couple of weeks. But his gold card is very good. 91 pace, 86 dribbling. I would say that maybe you could get a team of the week or inform Lozano if you'd like. That boosts the price just over 500,000 coins, which is why I didn't put him in this one. But you're not probably going to notice that much difference. Lozano is fast as well. They're both going to have very similar kind of feels in game. Well, the outcome is going to be the same. They're just going to be running up the wing and getting the ball back into the box for Benzema and Falcao. And of course, something I forgot to mention about Falcao, he has the outside the foot shot and finesse shot trait. These are all very valuable. Also power header as well, like crossing. I wouldn't say it's like back as it's the only way to score, but it's very viable as an option to cross the ball up tee it up for Falcao. And if he gets his head on the ball, the power header trait does actually make a big difference. I'm pretty sure Benzema has the outside the foot shot. Yes, he does, and finesse shot, which is why he can just score from outside the box with his holding LT basically and shooting outside the box. Amazing team this. The great thing is you don't need a manager to actually make this full chemistry. And that's why if you actually change Falcao out for any hero cards or even any icon card, maybe you've completed the 86 max icon card, you've got an attacker, you can take him out and you can actually still get full chemistry. If you don't have enough La Liga chemistry, you can just pick a manager that is going to be from La Liga Santander. So this is definitely the best team that you can build right now for 500,000 coins, in my opinion. There's a couple of Marmite players like Benzema. You know, he's either one of those players that you gel with and he's amazing, or you prefer smaller players like Ben Yedder. It's just down to preference, but I personally think this is amazing. If you enjoy these squad builders, guys, please remember to drop a like on the video. It means that my video is going to get into search results for you next time you search for a squad builder, and maybe even on your homepage if you enjoy squad builders that much. But also subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'm also going to put another video up here, and maybe you'll enjoy another squad builder or another video on my channel. I'll give you a couple of seconds to click on it before you leave, and I'll catch you guys later. Bye bye.